What is this expression? Yesterday I discussed. What is this? Chi
Yes,
equal
ma'am.
to epsilon r minus 1. Between which and between two things? What are they? What is its name and what is its name? The relation between dielectric constant
Dielectric
and
and the susceptibility. Susceptibility.
permeability. This is the relation. This is relation between dielectric constant and electrical susceptibility. Last day. Polarization processes. First one is electronic polarization. Second one is ionic polarization. Third one is orientational polarization. So polarization here. And already I have discussed this electronic polarization earlier. Polarization. The ionic polarization occurs when atoms and it is mainly due to a relative displacement of the atomic components of the molecule in the presence of an electric field. Electric field, when an electric field is applied to the molecule, the positive ions are displaced by, say, here x1, and negative ions are displaced by x2. Total resultant dipole moment, that mu, this is the expression I already discussed. Mu is the dipole moment. Mu equal to, it was q into d. It is, as it is, I have said, that is x1 and x2. It is explained here. So mu equal to q into x1 plus x2. So this is the resultant dipole moment. So what is x1? Displaced by negative ions, displaced by x2. So total dipole into plus position, say NaCl, and in NaCl this is the Na plus and this is Cl minus, and in this first figure without electric field, so no electric field is here. That what is happening applied, it is the direction shown, and this is x2. So what is x1? X1 is the positive ions are displaced by x1 and the negative ions are displaced by x2. So these are shown here. Now, this is the ionic polarization. Now, initially, there was some distance. This distance was there. So, charge into mu equal to q into d, you know. Now, this distance, now as a whole, this distance is now there. It is in, it has been increased. The distance has been increased. So, polarization will be induced. Say this is H plus. Say this distance is D. So what is the dipole moment? We can write plus C and minus C. I'm just taking as plus Q and minus Q like this. H plus and Cl minus. Just this is like plus Q and minus Q separated by some distance. So what is the dipole moment now? Mu equal to what? Charge into D. So I will write. So I will write charge Q and this distance. And this distance. That was initially D. Now say electric field is applied. This is H plus and electric field is applied. And now this distance is X. Say these are, what is the type of the HCl, polar or non-polar dielectrics? HCl is what type of dielectric material, polar or non-polar? Say something. ACL is polar dielectric or non-polar dielectric?
Polar.
Polar dielectric. Because in polar dielectrics, dipole moment exists even in the absence of the field. So this is the first figure where no field is there. Here it is E equal to zero. That means no field. So even in the absence of the field, dipole moment exists because two charges separated by some distance. So it will give the mu equal to QT. Now electric field is applied. Now here what is applied? Say electric field is applied. Now electric field is applied. Now what will happen? The positive charges will shift towards the direction of the field and negative charges opposite to the direction of the field. And as a result, some changes will be there, and let it is Q plus X. Say it is Q plus X, the distance now between these two. Now initially the dipole moment was mu equal to QD, and here what will be the extra dipole moment? Say mu equal to what? Okay, and Q, is it? Moment was there in HCl, but if it is electric field, then there will be an extra dipole moment. The length between these two ions has been changed now. Now it is Q plus X. Initially Q, not D. See, you are not saying anything. It is not Q. What is this? This is D. This is D. What is what? Initially it was D. Now it is D plus X. So what is the dipole, extra dipole moment induced? Anyone? The extra dipole moment induced when ACL is placed in an external electric field.
Ma'am, D plus X.
Now the distance has changed though. Has shifted their positions, and it is now the distance is D plus X in between these two, and initially say it was D. So the mu was Q into D, charge into distance. What will be?
QX.
Extra moment is Q into?
Q into X.
Because this is extra, and this is due to that electric field. This is due to that electric field, because when we apply electric field, the ions change their positions, and now their distance between the two ions, if it is increased, then by a distance X, then again dipole moment will be introduced extra distance, and this is QX. Now actually what is happening? Total dipole moment mu equal to what? Q into D plus X. This is the extra dipole moment. Mu equal to what? Q into D plus X. Because X is extra length that is introduced here. So the total dipole moment is this. That I'm just saying. How it is created. Now say, so this is ionic polarization. ACL is ionic molecule. If there is no electric field, but that if no electric field is there, there is some presence of dipole moment. Why? Because H plus and Cl minus, this is separated by some distance here, and you are getting the dipole moment as mu equal to QD. Now, if it is placed in an external electric field, then what will happen? Cl minus will change their positions. Now, if this distance is D plus X extra, then due to this extra X, another dipole moment will be introduced. So, polarization. So, dielectric polarization is there. So due to which? Due to ionic. So this is known as ionic polarization. So this is ionic polarization. It can be seen in HCl. It can be seen in NaCl. So these are all are polar dielectrics. These are all polar dielectrics, because if the electric field is also zero, but there exists permanent dipole moment, polar dielectrics. Examples, I already discussed these topics earlier. The figure that I was discussing about HCl, now it is in this figure, it is shown. This is NaCl. So you can see this is Na plus and this is Cl minus without electric field, and when it is with electric field, so you can see the distance has been changed, and now this is the extra, this is now mu equal to q into x1 plus x2. So as this distance has been changed, so some polarization is induced here, and this polarization is said as ionic polarization. Now next, orientational polarization. It is also called dipolar or molecular polarization. The molecules such as H2, N2, O2, Cl2, CCl4 carry any dipole because center of positive charges and the center of negative charges coincides. These are so these are the examples of what type of dielectrics. These are, if it is given H2, or H2 is the example of polar dielectric or non-polar dielectric.
Non-polar
dielectric. So these are the non-polar dielectrics. So, and what are the definitions of non-polar dielectrics? That is, in the absence of the field, there is no permanent dipole moment there. But if you apply the electric field, dipole moment arises. So these are the examples of. It's now come here. On the other hand, molecules like H2O. These are the HCl, CHCl, so ethyl acetate. So this carries dipoles even in the absence of the electric field. You know, I have just discussed about HCl molecules. They have permanent dipole moment. However, the net dipole moment is negligibly small since all the molecular dipoles are oriented randomly when there is no electric field. Polar dielectrics, these are all called polar dielectrics, but they are the dipole moment is there, but what is happening there, the dipole moments are randomly oriented, their orientation are not fixed in a particular direction, so they are randomly oriented. If you consider H2O, their dipole moment exists, but are randomly oriented. So when you are taking the sum of this, all these dipole moments, so some dipole moments are canceling each another, so the total effective dipole moment is less. But if you put electric field, then what will happen? All the dipoles orient themselves in the direction of the field. As a result, the net dipole moment becomes enormous. I'm going to the whiteboard. I'm just drawing there. So it is already drawn here in my PPT. So these are called orientational polarization. So how it is? So see here, E equal to zero. That is, what is the meaning of E equal to zero? That means there is no field. So I am just considering first said that H2O molecule. H2 I am considering. H2 is electric. That means even in the absence of the field, you will get polarization. Now, what will happen? These are the dipoles. Dipole exists even in the absence of the field. So equal to zero, but it is showing that there are, but you can see there are different directions. The directions are different. This dipole is oriented in this direction. This dipole is oriented in a straightforward upward direction. This is along downward direction. So if we consider these two dipoles, this one and this one, then what will happen? This one and this one, they will, but this is upward, this is downward. Then what will happen? What will be the net dipole moment for these two? This dipole and this dipole, if I am just considering only two these dipoles, then what will happen? For these two dipoles? Say something.
Ma'am, zero.
Zero. So they are canceling with each other. So as again, if I consider like this, it is going in this direction, and it is coming from this direction. So again, canceling. So in this way, many of the dipole moments are, when we are taking the net, then total net contribution of the dipole moment is less. Okay, because many of the dipoles are canceling each other. actually in H2 you will get dipole moment, but as the dipoles are oriented randomly, so if we take the total contribution of the dipole moment, the net value of the dipole moment in that material, this is not large, because many of the cancelling each other. But if you applied any electric field, then what will happen? So E greater than zero, that means something field is applied here, then dipoles are oriented along the direction of the field. All the dipoles are oriented along the directions of the field. So no cancellation of the dipole moment is there in the second figure. So all the dipoles are contributing to the net dipole moment of the material. The total dipole moment will be enormous. We will get enormous value of the dipole moment here in the second figure. Is it? Can you see any cancellation that it is coming in this direction and another it is coming in this direction? No. All the dipoles are arranged in the direction of the field. So no cancellation of the dipole moment. So here we are getting enormous dipole moment. So this is, so now if dipole moment we are getting, that means polarization. So this is the polarization. That means the dipoles which were randomly distributed, now upon applying the electric field, the dipoles are in a particular direction. Now, as they are orientation of the dipoles are changed and all the dipoles are oriented in the field direction, so polarization is occurring here. Dipole moment, the net value of the dipole moment is increasing enormously in the second case. So this is called orientational polarization. Meaning of this. So there are three types of polarization. One is electronic polarization, second one is ionic polarization, and the third one is orientational polarization. So you have to explain. So if it is given, what is a short answer type question? What is dielectric polarization? Then you will write in two lines first, then you will explain that there are three types. Discussed what is dielectric polarization. So you will write it in two lines. Then you will write there are three types of dielectric polarization: electronic polarization, ionic polarization, and orientational polarization. And so for everything, for every polarization, you will draw the figure. If you are not explaining in language also, and you can explain in your language also, but figures are very important. So if you draw the figure and only write one line, that will be sufficient. But you have to draw. Drawing is very important. Electronic polarization, then you charge electron cloud, you will draw. Then when E equal to zero, then you will draw what is the position, the centroid of the nucleus and the electron cloud, they are coinciding. And when you are giving the field, then electrons and that the centroid of the nucleus and the electron cloud, they are separated. Now some dipole moment is induced inside the atom. So that is the electronic polarization. The figure already given in your note. Ionic polarization, you can draw any molecule, that is HCl and NaCl, H plus Cl minus. So there you will explain how ionic polarization is occurring, and orientational polarization due to the orientation of the dipoles. In the dipoles are any oriented because field and all the dipoles are oriented in a particular direction, giving enormous value of the dipole moment. So these are all about these three types of polarization. Important expression for electronic polarization. So the expression for electronic polarization. Consider an atom in an electric field of intensity. Since the nucleus, what is the charge of the nucleus? Ze. Ze is the charge of the nucleus plus Ze, and the electron, if it is plus Ze, then the electron cloud is obviously minus Ze. So these two Ze are same. It is small and it is big. So don't confused with this. So these are totally Ze, same. These two Ze are same. So just in your, when you will write in your copy, just put it as capital Z. So consider atom in an electric field of intensity. Since the nucleus, if the nucleus has charge plus Ze, the electron cloud has charge minus Ze, because the total charge will be zero. Atom has opposite charges acted upon by Lorentz force. So FL is the Lorentz force. the nucleus, when we apply the field, then what will happen? The nucleus will be direct, the nucleus will be move the direction of the field and the electron cloud in the opposite direction. So if I give field, then this will happen. Now when electron cloud and the nucleus get shifted from their normal positions, an attractive force is created. Attractive force between them is, so it is between B/AW. So attractive force is created between them, and the separation continues until Coulombic force Fc is balanced with Lorentz force. So the finally a new equilibrium state is established where Coulomb force will be balanced by the Lorentz force. Now the expression of the two forces I am just writing. So what I am discussing, this is electronic polarization. So atom is there, positively charged nucleus is there, and negatively charged electron cloud is there. Now if we apply electric field, then both of them will displace the position, will be displaced. Now there, here, that is, so they are shifted from their normal positions and an attractive force is created between them, and the separation continues. That means this displacement between the nucleus and the electron cloud, it will Coulombic force Fc is balanced by the Lorentz force. Now in the new equilibrium position, what will happen? So this is the figure. This is plus Zd and this is the electron cloud outside. So this is no field. And the second one, that is the field. Say this is the, it was the position initial, and then now it is the position of the nucleus. So it has been shifted. It has been shifted. Now this is the direction of the electric field. So in figure 2, represent the displacement of the nucleus and the electron cloud, and we assume that the negative charge in the cloud uniformly distributed over a sphere of radius r. Now sigma, now here come. So figure 2 represents displacement of nucleus and electron cloud, and we assume that the negative charge in the cloud uniformly distributed over a sphere of radius r. So you can see this is the sphere of radius r, this is the sphere of radius r. So the cloud uniformly distributed over this sphere, and the spherical shape does not change for convenience, and total this shape is not changed, only the position is changed. Now it is shifted from nucleus from this point to this point. The surface charge density of the sphere, so this is the figure sphere now. So we are considering that the surface charge density of the sphere, this is sigma. Now sigma equal to what? This is minus Zd by 4 pi r cube. So minus Zd is what represents the total charge of the in the sphere. So that is the negative, that is the electron cloud is there. So I am taking here minus Zd. So sigma equal to what? The surface charge density of the sphere. What is this? This is minus Zd by 4/3 pi r cube. This is the volume of the sphere, 4/3 pi r cube divided by volume. So charge divided by volume, this is the surface charge density of the sphere of radius r. Negative charge in the sphere of radius x is, now this is the sphere of, what is the, this is x. Now what is this distance? Because the nucleus is shifted from this position to this position. Now this is the, now this is this this sphere, this small sphere, this small sphere has a radius. What is the radius? This is x. So what this is written here, thus the negative charge in the sphere of radius x is, what is the negative charge? This is qe. What is this? This is sigma into this volume. Our surface charge density of the sphere, that means what? Charge per unit volume. So sigma is the charge per unit volume. So per unit volume, the charge in per unit volume is sigma. Now if the volume is 4/3 pi x cube, now what is the volume of the this small sphere? This small sphere, say anyone? A sphere has a radius small x. What is the volume?
4/3 pi x cube.
4/3 pi x cube. Now come here. So what will be the charge inside this sphere? So what is the surface stress density of the total sphere? What is the surface stress density of the total sphere? Sigma, is it? You know what is the charge per unit volume? Per unit volume में कितना charge है ये तो तुम लोग जानते हो, ठीक है? तो per unit volume में charge जानते हो, तो ये small जो sphere है इसका volume भी जानते हो. ये क्या है? 4/3 pi x³. तो 4/3 pi x³ में कितना charge होगा? बोलो. See what will be the charge inside this small sphere of a volume 4/3 pi x³. बोलो बोलो कोई भी बोलो.
इसका वॉल्यूम इनटू सिग्मा.
सिग्मा. सो सिग्मा इज द सरफेस स्ट्रेस डेंसिटी, दैट इज द चार्ज पर यूनिट वॉल्यूम, यू नो, एंड फ्रॉम हियर एंड यू नो द वॉल्यूम ऑफ द स्मॉल स्फीयर एंड इफ यू मल्टीप्लाई यू विल गेट. सो इट इज मल्टीप्लाइड. नाउ दिस वैल्यू इज डायरेक्टली रिटन देयर एंड कैलकुलेटेड. सो व्हाट इज दिस क्यूई एक्सप्रेशन? सो माइनस जेड बाय आर क्यू इनटू एक्स क्यू. सो क्वेश्चन नंबर 1. Now the so two forces I explained. One is Coulomb force and Lorentz force. F for force and C for Coulomb and L for Lorentz. So two forces we will write and we will equate them. So FC means Coulomb force. So if you know Coulomb force equal to what? Q1 Q2 by 4 pi epsilon 0 r squared. Do you know this expression of Coulomb force? You know though.
Yes, ma'am.
So what is?
Yes, ma'am.
What is this? Q1 Q2 by 4 pi epsilon 0 r squared. Is it?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Same expression I have written. Same expression I have written. So now, same expression it is written here, and I have written the two charges. Two charges means minus ZD. x³ / r³. That means this one. Okay, this one. This is what? This is QE. It is written. So QE. What is QE? QE is the charge, negative charge, in the sphere of radius x. So already we have calculated this value of QE. So I have given. So this is the 1/4 pi epsilon 0 r squared. So it is kept outside. So I'm writing Q1 and Q2. You know FC Coulomb force equal to 1/4 pi Q1 Q2 by 4 pi epsilon 0 r squared, like this. Now 4 pi epsilon 0 r squared. That term here it is 4 pi epsilon 0 x squared. I'm just putting it forward. Now what next? That is Q1 and Q2. Now this is your Q1 and this is your Q2. So Q1 is here QE. So already I have calculated. And what is QP? This is ZE. So ZE, that is the charge of the nucleus. Now this is the charge of the nucleus. Now, so these are the two charges, QE and QP. Now this value is given as this. Just calculate, you will get giving it equation number 2. So already I have expression of Coulomb force. Now what I'm writing? Coulomb force, force experienced by displaced nucleus of strength E, electric field strength E is what? FL. FL equal to UQ. Lorentz force. Do you know anyone the expression of Lorentz force? QE. Are you familiar with this Lorentz force? Anyone? When a charged particle is placed in an electric field, so what will be the force experienced by the charged particle? This is given by Lorentz force. Okay, L of charge. When a charged particle having charge Q, it is placed in an external electric field, then the force experienced by the charged particle is the Lorentz force. And what is the expression of the Lorentz force? This is FL equal to E into Q. And what is our Q here? It is ZE. Q equal to ZE. So ZD into E, equation of Lorentz force. Equation of Lorentz force. So say anyone, what is the Lorentz force? What I explained? When a, I have just said now. What is Lorentz force? Say anyone. So then I will think that you are not listening what I am explaining. Say. Say anyone say something.
Up to the two different type of transmission.
What is Lorentz force?
Force experienced by a charged particle in the presence of electric field.
Yes. So when a charge is placed in an electric field, the force experienced by that charged particle is the Lorentz force, and this is equal to E into Q. And already this charge of the nucleus, it is Ze. So Ze into Q, Ze into E. So Ze into E. So Q equal to Ze here, the charge of the nucleus. So it is Ze into E. Now the two forces will balance each other, Lorentz force and Coulomb force. Now initially I have calculated Fc equal to this. Now I'm just writing this one Fc, and this is the Fl. So we are equating these two, and just calculation, simple calculation, and from there I'm calculating alpha E. Alpha E is there. I'm just putting here the expression of E is here. E. This is dipole moment by alpha E. So I'm just putting it here, and from here I'm getting alpha E. So remember this one. This is a very important relation. Alpha equal to 4 pi epsilon 0 r cube. So alpha equal to 4 pi epsilon 0 r cube. So hence, now what is alpha E? Electronic polarizability. Alpha E is the electronic polarizability. Here in this place, E, in this place I have written Ze. Ze into x divided by alpha E. So this is dipole moment by alpha E. Actually, this is dipole moment by alpha E. This is E. The value of E I have given here. So in this way, I'm getting here alpha E equal to 4 pi epsilon 0 r cube. Since the electronic polarizability, here you can also write in place of S, Z. Electronic polarizability directly proportional to the cube of the radius of the atom. So R is the radius of the atom. So Q of the radius of the atom, it may be given in MCQ and also for your numerical. So remember this formula, alpha equal to this, R cube, 4 pi epsilon 0 R cube is there. Very important. This is proportional to R cube. Very important. Mark it, this one. And the last thing that I said last day, that in alpha equal to epsilon 0, epsilon R minus 1 by N, this proof is very important. This is the expression of electronic polarizability. Now we know P equal to N mu. That thing I have already derived earlier. And N mu, mu equal to again alpha E into E. Go through the previous notes, then you will get everything. So P equal to this and mu equal to alpha into E. Again, P equal to epsilon 0 chi into E. When I discussed susceptibility, the expression of susceptibility, then I wrote this thing. Epsilon 0 chi into E. So every expressions are there from our previous notes. So I have only what I have done, only used the formulas. So it is written here. Then epsilon 0 E. So chi, what is the expression of chi? At the starting of my class, I discussed the relation between electrical susceptibility and the dielectric constant. And what is this? That is chi E equal to epsilon R minus 1. So that value I am just putting here, epsilon 0 chi E into E, 0 E, and the value of chi E equal to epsilon R minus 1. So the expression of P equal to this, again another expression of P equal to this. So we can equate this two. So N alpha E into E equal to what? Epsilon 0 E into epsilon R minus 1. So from there easily we can calculate the value of epsilon alpha E, that is the electronic polarizability, that is equal to epsilon 0 into epsilon R minus 1 divided by capital N. So this expression is very, very important. So here in this lecture, what we have? The expression of electronic polarizability. This is expression of electronic polarizability. Gives the relation with the polarizability with the radius of the atom. So if the radius of the atom is increased, electronic polarizability will again increase. So this is same thing. But two expressions are there. Alpha E has this expression also. And then the second step, alpha E has also this expression. And these two expressions are very important. And especially this expression is frequently given in when you have offline exam, in different offline exam, it was given this particular problem, the expression of electronic, deduce this one. It is given directly. So this is also very important. And if online exam, then that write down the expression. So this is also important. Now this actually just just go through the next part, but these are not actually very important for you. So here, this part you will remember, Clausius Mosotti relation. This one you will read after this. Whatever I have discussed today, after this you will read this one. Read and just you will write these two lines. You will read these two lines and this one. Last one. This is the expression n alpha I by 3 epsilon 0 epsilon r minus 1 epsilon r plus 2. This is the Clausius Mosotti relation. If you can derive, then okay. Then leave it up to this and only write, only read what is this relation and the derivation. And that means the last part. This is the, remember this one. In two lines, you will write what is this equation or this relation. Then this expression you will remember, because there are the notes are given in detail, very detailed, and everything is not included in your syllabus also. It is given only two lectures in dialectics, and if I want to go through all this, then it will take five lectures or six lectures. If at last I get time after completing my syllabus, then definitely I will discuss this in detail. But these are not actually included in detail in your syllabus. But this relation is important. Remember and mark it. This relation is important. What is this relation? Maybe given question. And this relation, that is the final expression of Clausius Mosotti relation, that you will remember. So of dielectric material, what are the types? You will remember. That means it can be solid, liquid, gas. Just go through it. So the types of the dielectric material. So these are the examples of solid dielectric materials. So mica, glass, asbestos, rubber, ceramics, different ceramics. These are the material. Liquid dielectric material, different oil, mineral insulating oil, synthetic insulating oil. Gaseous dielectric material, nitrogen, sulfur, hexafluoride, inert gases. So these are the gaseous dielectric materials. Application of dielectrics, why? In capacitors, in transformers, in polymeric flame, electrolytic, powder and distribution transformers and other applications. So these are the different applications of the dielectric material. So now ending my lecture today. Time is over almost. What is the time? It's 11:55. So this is the end of dielectrics. So you will remember. Say.
Ma'am.
Say.
मैम एग्जाम कैसे होगा ऑनलाइन में?
ऑनलाइन में गूगल, सुनो हमें गूगल मीट का लिंक भेजेंगे, ठीक है? जैसे क्लास होता है, तुम लोगों का कितना है? फोर्थ को है ना एग्जाम?
यस मैम.
यस मैम.
फ्रॉम 10 AM?
यस
मैम.
आई विल गिव वन गूगल मीट लिंक इन द सेम मैनर as I give for classes, different classes. So same link will be given on your video and you will give the exam. You will just write in your all the answers there. I will share it in through Google Classroom. In Google Classroom, I will give the questions. You will complete writing, you will scan it and you will upload it in there, in Google Classroom. Clear?
Okay.
So you, all of you have to on your video on that day.
Okay.
So prepare yourself for that. So you will on your video, you will write all the questions. Then after writing, then what you will do, you will just upload it in Google Classroom. 1 hour I will not consider. Those who will submit later, I will not consider. So you have to submit within 1 hour, and there will be MCQ questions and also short answer type question. In MCQ you get options. So that means all the questions you have to attempt, all the questions, no extra. In MCQ options will be given, and they are short answer type question. There what you will get, you will get 2 and 3 marks question, short answer type question. Numericals also you will get. Understand?
solve it on A4 sheet.
Okay, ma'am.
You can do it in your copy, but you actually, I need your, no, just do it in A4 sheet. If in a future you have to submit, then it will be problematic for you. Also, you can do it in your copy, but you, that copy you have to save. Matter if it is said that you have to submit the assignments, hard copy, or copy it may be problematic. So do it in your A4 sheet paper. That will be easier for you. No restriction from my side. Whatever you wish, do it. My opinion that you can write it in A4 paper. That means a letter, if you have to submit the assignments, then it will be easier to submit in paper. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
Lecture here.